Just get down there. Yeah. Thank you. Right then, it's the academic, lovely. Do check him out tonight at the Indra at 9:30. Now, cynic Stefan, our stage manager, without him, none of this would be possible. Because all of the bands... all of the bands, as you probably know by now, only have like 10 seconds of sound check in between the seminars and now. So they're really patient with us, and I think everything's ready. There were cynics amongst us, ladies and gentlemen, that said we would never get this band to come on this stage. There were people who said, you won't get them. So we sent them an email, and they said yes immediately. And I hope they're happy with that decision. Will you give it up for the one, the only, Rudimental?
Falling down, it won't even matter to us. No, it won't even matter to us. Oh, we could risk it all. We'll fight until we fall. Yeah. Oh, we can risk it.
Feels really nice. So that was a song called I Will For Love. It comes out, the album We The Generation comes out on the 2nd of October. So, yeah, if you have any money, please buy it.
Son of a woman, word is on the street. I don't know how to feel about what you say to me. I, cause the party pills, they won't give me no relief. I, nothing but a cheap girl, no chance of a remedy, no. Bad things be spreading round, no, let it go, just turn it down. Don't be a fool, don't be a clown. Can't tell me, won't tell me nothing anyhow. Bad things be spreading round, no, let it go, just turn it down. Either way, I'm coming round, can't tell me, won't turn me down. I don't even care about what they say. I don't even care about what they say, no. I don't even care, no, about what they say, yeah.
It's on the roof of my mouth, what is on the street? I love so, the feeling is bittersweet. How'd you like me now? I'm at the crossroads you can't meet. Don't test me now, cause it's a test that you can't cheat. The bad things be spread around, no, let it go, just turn it down. Won't be a fool, won't be a clown, can't tell me, won't tell me nothing anyhow. Bad things be spread around, no,
let it go, just turn it down.
Either way I'm coming round, can't tell me, won't turn me down. I don't even care about what they say. I don't even care what they say. I don't even care about what they say,
join us. Yeah, come and have a, I'll just have a quick chat. I will. Microphones. Welcome.
Thank you,
welcome. Any drinks necessary?
I had one somewhere.
Yes, lots of drinks, please.
Lots of drinks, Phil.
No, it's cool.
You're all right.
We've got lots of things here. Thanks.
And you're playing tonight quite late.
Yeah, we're playing at Reaper Barn. Yeah,
late tonight. Welcome.
Thank you
for joining us. It's a bit confusing for me because you never know who you're going to get with Rudimental, do you? And I know we've got Will. Who have we got?
There's actually sort of four core members of Rudimental. Yeah. Two of them are actually ill today. So we kind of threw this together last minute for you.
Yeah.
But this is Will Hurd. He's a singer that features heavily on our new album.
I'm the new one.
I just dropped in. Now, we'll talk about that in a minute, but you've often collaborated with outside singers. Is it fair to say that you're some sort of collective, like Soul to Soul would have been in the 90s?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Soul to Soul, Massive Attack, those are our influences, you know. Us two, we do a lot of the production. There's another two who aren't here. And we bring in singers that influence us and inspire us, like Will, Anne-Marie, Tom Jules, Beanie on the cajon. He's usually a drummer. And, yeah, we just make music together as a collective.
And what does
kind of orchestrate it. So.
Yeah, well, what does that do when you bring in people from outside? Because normally you're a band, you're together, you know what you sound like, you know what you want, yeah. And then people come from outside, you just let it freely, organically grow.
I mean, we started on pirate radio, we were kind of jungle and grime and garage and that kind of stuff, but we're influenced by soul, you know. I grew up listening to Marvin Gaye and that kind of stuff, so we combine the two, and having access to different singers, it's like having a palette to choose from. Do you know what I mean? It's like you could be stuck with one voice, one sound, but it's amazing to be able to pick something as we evolve and change as we evolve.
And luckily, I don't limit my research to Wikipedia, because you never can. Because Wikipedia says, Rudimental, electronic group from England, from Hackney. Big up, Bernie. Bernie's from Hackney.
Big up, Bernie.
Got to stick together, you Hackney boys. But you sort of bridged the gap between, like, you know, I mean, really credible dance music, good pop tunes, very emotional stuff. Was that something you set out to do as well?
I don't know if we set out to do anything, really. You know, I mean, it kind of fell together. But, you know, it's all because of our influences, man. I mean, we make dance music, but I'm not sure if it can be classed as that anymore, because I guess that was dance music, but, you know, it's more like dance music like Sly and the Family Stone or James Brown. Those are our kind of influences.
I think when we're in the studio and we're making or creating and producing songs, this is how we start out. We start out with the core instruments and all the production side of things, and the electronic sound comes afterwards. So I think that's what fuses the live and electronic together really well.
Right. And then what you speak about influences, and that's what was great about it. I once saw you speaking about people like Parliament, Funkadelic, George Clinton.
George.
I mean, that's one of the best interviews I think I've ever done in my entire life.
Amazing.
I wasn't sure he knew he was there, George. I interviewed him when I was on MTV in the 90s.
Yeah.
And he was just coming out of his very bad period, so he was happy.
Oh, wicked, he was coming out.
It was amazing, yeah.
He's amazing. He's on very, my record, actually.
And Soul, you're very much... you also have a great old... I mean, he's gone now. Bobby Womack is on the new album isn't he?
Yeah.
And Damon Albarn did a lot to bring Bobby Womack back. Yeah. So the second album, when you went in, was there... you said you don't set out to do anything. It all just falls together. Was there a criteria that you wanted something with this new album, We
The Generation? As far as, you know... making music for us, it's kind of like a snapshot of where we've been for the last 2 years, which has been touring the world heavily. So we picked up a lot of influences from everywhere, but we take it back to Hackney, where our studio is, and finish it, you know. So yeah, the soul influence growing up is a big influence on this album, more so than the first one, which was called Home. Obviously Bobby Womack was on there. Bobby, we started a relationship with him when we did a TV show together a couple of years ago, and he came up to us. It was Jules Holland in UK. He came up to us after we performed, and he was like, "Man, that was incredible," and all this stuff. He's like, "You sure? are you with us?" And he was really, really cool, and we exchanged numbers and basically stayed in touch over a period of time. His health deteriorated rapidly. And while we were on tour in America, we were on a tour bus in Arizona. Our tour bus had broken down, and our generator was gone. We had a studio on the bus. We had like a drum kit in there and amps and everything. I'm feeling kind of uninspired, but we got an email from his wife with a request that he had asked us to finish a song that he started called New Day Coming. So she sent us the vocal that he'd recorded, and we jammed an idea based on a guitar riff that I had from many years before that. And it happened to be in the same key, and it was in the same tempo as well, so just the synergy was amazing. And we hope we did it justice, a song called New Day on our album. And you also mentioned George Clinton, who appears on there a couple of times as well.
So brilliant.
It's kind of a mixture of the new and the old.
There's something about you guys, it's about the soul, isn't it? It's the soul. And you're very, you want to spend positivity a lot about it. I mean, because when I grew up, you know, you had the hippies and the punks and the acid house, and we all had sort of movements to join, but now doesn't seem to be really anything. They're all over the place. But you've got this very positive message that you want to spread.
Sure, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, when you look at us, we're like a family. We call ourselves the kind of Rudimental family. On our first album, we sort of launched a number of careers for vocalists that was up and coming. We gave them a great platform in the likes of John Newman, Ella Eyre, M&EK, Becky Hill, Sinead, tons of artists. And the new album, we want to do a similar thing. We're providing a great platform for the likes of Will Hurd, Anne-Marie, who you saw with us, and many more up and coming talents. And we're definitely a family and movement, and that's how we like to act, and I think the next album we'll be looking for that new talent again.
Great, and I'm glad to see as well that on the website, because what we're missing these days with all the streaming and the downloads is the artwork for old school people like me to find all things, but it's the lyrics, you know, and every song has got the lyrics on the website for the new album. So obviously that's something important as well.
Yeah, I mean, we pour our emotions into it, you know, so it's quite important for us. It's not just dance music for the club or for the festival, it's also emotional music, so it's good to for people to read the lyrics and see what it's actually about.
Well, long may you reign, Rudimental.
Thank you, mate.
And thank you for taking the time out of your busy schedule to be here. Will, just one thing. Can I have a touch of your cashmere? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Rudimental, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thanks, guys. Thank you.